And there were big clouds that were in the sky. That's right. Big, heavy, puffy clouds. And they were very, very heavy because inside they had sheets of rain that went down and down and down. And they kept going down to the ground. And on the ground, there was little buds of flowers and little leaves of grass that were getting the water. And the water was seeping into the ground. And so then it kept raining down and raining down. And the wind kept blowing side to side and side to side. Later on, the clouds are going to part and they're going to go up and to the sides and up in a way. That's beautiful, Heather. That's exactly what the clouds are going to do.
And I'm just going to skip to the end, but mostly it's the reason I kept this much on here is to show you how long this had to last in order to have the effect that I'm looking for, which is deep relaxation and just kind of a hypnotic
sense. On the moon, on the waves of Lake Michigan, like little rays of light. And that is the weather for Chicago. That was a good weather. You got good at that.
Yeah, well, at the end, his smile is just beautiful. He's just in a beatific state. Now, having lived in Chicago, I just went back there in my mind when you went through that. And it's a pretty accurate description of weather patterns. And I started to think about springtime and rain and the storms and life, and on the weekends we lived 8 blocks from Lake Michigan, so I would walk there, and so you know I was back in that rhythm of what you were doing, which was very comfortable and very, you know, I was going to say biological, or when we talk about nature, it doesn't have to be physiological within our body. It can be within the atmosphere and the environment we walk through.
The storytelling aspect, the prosodic voice, the imagery, there's a rhythm to it, and that each phase lasted a while.
Yeah.
So that the whole thing was rolling out kind of makes people feel like they're in the story, and they sort of lose their sense of the of hypervigilance or what else is going on, and that's why it has to last a while for it to really take effect.
There's one other point, and that is usually, especially with children, there's hypersensitivity to the back. Mm-hmm. And really what you're showing is that there's trust. And as we experience more and more, the trust is an enabler for expanding those experiences. Mm-hmm. And that was the duration. So if you take what you did with the pull me back, or whatever the one was, the slide, where it slowed up this falling back, this slowed up the stimulation, tactile stimulation of the back, which is a trigger for many children to turn around or to get up and reciprocate in a not necessarily nice way.
Right. So what I'm reading into what you're saying is the rhythm and the how long every aspect lasts helps the parent to regulate the movement in accordance with it, so that it doesn't become ticklish and dysregulating. So it's kind of co-facilitated.
There's one other important point, and that is the prosodic aspect of the voice,
right?
Which is in itself an intervention unto itself. You know, it is. It is a calming, because that's what our nervous system wants to hear: the melodic voice, the maternal melodic voice, which says, I'm safe, touch me, I'm not going to react. So you're layering different strategies. You're layering the intonation of voice with the gentleness of touch, with the rhythm of touch, and with the narrative. So there's multiple layers there.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Right, exactly. That's why I think this is a really powerful intervention, especially in the connection between the therapist and the parent, as they become regulated and are able to provide that.
That's a profound point. It's the therapist with the parent as well. Because a parent doing that with a watching a video without being in the presence of the therapist may not be as effective. Mm-hmm. And that, you know, so in doing that with video conferencing is a challenge because you have to project presence. The presence of the therapist is, in a sense, the overall container of the dyad between the child and the mother.
That's exactly right. And that's the sort of the challenge or the art of doing therapy online with children and anybody, but especially dyads, where there's a dysregulated partner of the dyad, which is sometimes it's the child and sometimes it's the parent and sometimes it's both. That your presence has to be all the more resonant and containing in order to regulate it and make it a safe experience.